మ్యామ్ మీరు మ్యూట్ లో ఉన్నారు మ్యామ్.
ఓకే, వి షల్ కంటిన్యూ. ప్రిన్సిపల్ ఆఫ్ ఆపరేషన్ అండ్ కంట్రోల్ టెక్నిక్స్. సో నౌ వి విల్ గో ఫర్ చాపర్, క్లాస్ ఏ చాపర్. Okay, so this is called as class A chopper and it is also called as single quadrant chopper, operating chopper. Okay, so this is also having other names. I will say you after the further classes how the name and else also you will get. So this is class A chopper. If you see the circuit diagram here, you are having voltage V. So this is a direct source voltage. So this V is a direct source voltage and it is supplying an inductive load. It is supplying an inductive load through a switch called self-commutated semiconductor switch. Okay, so this symbol, this symbol of self-commutated semiconductor switch, this V, we are using this symbol for this switch because if you take a chopper, it is, this chopper can be built using any device. Okay, so suppose if you take a thyristor with a forced commutation circuit, or if you take a CTO, or if you take a power transistor or MOSFET, whatever it is, it can be built, chopper can be built. Okay, so of already these switches are explained before to you in classes. So the reason of taking this switch is the chopper can be built with any type of self-commutated semiconductor switches. So see here, the diode, if you see the next one, the diode DF. Okay, so this diode DF will be showing the direction in which the device carries current. Okay, it shows the direction in which the device can carry current. So this DF is connected parallel with the load. Okay, and see here, the operation of chopper will be synchronized with the AC source voltage. So if you synchronize the operation of this, you can improve the line power factor and you can reduce the armature current ripples. Okay, so now we will go to the explanation, principle of operation and control techniques. So before going to the explanation, see here, again this switch, when the control signal is present, see here, so the if the semiconductor switch S is periodically operated with a period of T, and it will be remaining, it will be closer, it will be remaining closer time for T on is equal to delta T. Okay, so this switch DF is connected as the, sorry, as the diode is connected to parallel to the load, we are opening and closing the switch in order to allow the current to flow through the diode. So when the switch is operated periodically with a period T, and the time off time, the closer time of the switch will be T on is equal to delta T. So from 0 to, with the limits 0 to 1. Okay, so now what we are calling the delta as T on by T, this is called as duty ratio or duty cycle of the chopper. Okay, you can see in the figure 4, this one, you can see in the figure here, it shows the waveforms of control signal IC. This is the control signal IC. Okay, so this control signal IC, it will be a base current for a transistor chopper. Okay, and next, gate current for GTO. Gate current for GTO of a GTO chopper. So this IC will be, what it will be? It will be a base current for the transistor chopper and a gate current for can be a base current for the transistor chopper. For the transistor, it can be a base current. And for the GTO, it is the current of the GTO. And for the, finally, for the thyristor, it is the main thyristor current. Okay? Suppose if you use MOSFET also, it will be a gate to source voltage. Okay? So, for four types, it will be a current IC. So, when the control signal is present, that means when this pulse is present, from here we observe that the pulse is present from 0 to delta T. So, when the, we will say that when the control signal is present, the semiconductor switch S will be conduct if forward bias. So, if it is forward bias, the diode is forward bias, the switch will be in conduction. That means the switch will be in on position. Okay, so if you turn off the IC, that means if you turn off the pulse, see, from delta T to 2T period, there is no pulse. So if you turn off this IC current, this chopper circuit we are designing such that if you turn off the IC current, the switch will be off. If you turn on the IC current, if you give control signals only, the switch will be present. If you give away the control signals, the switch will be off. So basically the switch will be on when the diode is forward biased and we are giving control signals. When control signals are given, automatically diode will be forward biased. So when the diode is forward biased, the switch will be on. Okay, so during the interval, you are having, during the interval of the switch, you are having two types of intervals. Okay, so you are having two types. First one is called duty interval and second one is called freewheeling interval. See here, this is duty interval. This is called as during 0 to delta T, the interval is called as during 0 to delta T, the interval is called as duty interval. At this time, switch is on and control signal is given. And from delta T to T, capital T, see here, from delta T to capital T, it is called as freewheeling interval. Right? So, in this freewheeling interval, the switch is off. That means no control signal, so switch is off. So, once we will go through these intervals, assume the first interval, take the first interval, duty interval. So, the duty interval is the interval between 0 to delta T, right? Okay. So, in this interval of switch, the load is subjected to voltage. The load is having a voltage of V. Okay. The load voltage is V. And the current will be increasing from IA1 to IA2. IA1 to IA2. And the voltage is V. If you observe the waveforms, you can see. So, I will show you the graph and I will explain you. You can see the graph directly without theory. So, see here, from 0 to T, what is the value of VA? The load is subjected to voltage V. And the load current will be increasing. This is IA is the load current. See here, IA is the load current. And load voltage is VA. VA is V. Okay. So, load voltage is V. And load current IA will be rising from IA1 to IA2. Okay. Now, the switch is opening at S, delta T. The switch will be again open here, delta T. Okay. So, this is called as off period of the switch, right? No signals, no control signals. So, this is termed as off period of the switch. So, at this half period, that means at freewheeling interval, from intervals delta T to T, what happens, see here? The load inductance will be maintaining the flow of current through DF, okay? So, this allows the flow of current through DF. So, now what becomes the voltage value in the load? The voltage value will be simply flowing to zero. So, it falls to it stays zero. Okay, and here we are seeing that the diode drop, the drop across the diode will be applied here, as both are parallel, voltage will be equal. Okay, so but I am taking, I am neglecting the voltage drop in the diode, and I am simply saying that P is equal to zero. Okay, so in practical there will be a diode drop across here, that means VA here small, but we are neglecting. Okay, so this is the low terminal voltage. And what about the current? The current will be decreasing from IA2 to IA1. Okay, so this is the, again here the switch ons, S ons, because I am giving the control signals, the switch will be on. Again IA1 to IA2 current increases, and voltage increases from 0 to V, sorry. So this is the continuous cycle. And here diode DF, it provides, diode DF will be providing a path for the total load current to flow, total load current to flow when the switch is off. Okay, it provides a path for the load current to flow when the switch is off. So what happens, this improves the load current waveform. And if you further see that, you will maintain a continuity of load current at turn off. It also prevents transient voltage from appearing across the switch. Okay, so this is done due to sudden change of current, load current. Okay, so why you are taking the DF here? What is the function of DF here? It provides a path for the load current when the switch is off. When the switch is off, it provides a path for the load current, so that the current is continuous. So if continuity of current is maintained, what happened? It prevents transient voltage appearing across the switch. Due to the sudden load current, there will be some transient voltage appearing across the switch. But if you put one diode here, this prevents the sudden appearance of voltage at the switch, sudden transient voltage appearing at the switch. Okay, so the source current will be flowing only during the duty interval. And what is the value? It is equal to the load current. The source current equal to load current at the duty interval. Okay, so see, this is the source current. What is the value? What is the value? Equal to load current only, IA2. At delta T, IA2. At delta 0, IA1. So this is the source current. So now we will see the equations. The direct component or average value of the load current is given by VA is equal to 1 by T 0 to T VA dt. At 0, the value is VA. At 0 to T, the value is VA. And 0 to delta T, the value is only V. Okay, so both are equal and both are getting same values, delta V. Okay, so see about the switch. Now we concentrate about the switch. The switch can be controlled in two various forms. Okay, so this controlling is done by varying the duty ratio, delta is equal to T on by T. What is the duty ratio? Delta is equal to T on by T. So if you vary the delta, you can control the switch. So there are two. All of you please mute. So there are two control techniques. First one is time ratio control. And second PRC, and second one is current limit control, CLC. Okay, so this PRC is also called as pulse width control. You will know about in future, pulse width modulation, pulse width control. So this time ratio control is also called as pulse width control. denominator is fixed. Okay, and this tion is varied. Okay, so if T is fixed and tion is varied, then we can vary the beauty ratio delta. And second one, what is second one? Variable frequency TRC. Okay, reverse of first one. First, we have to keep the T on constant here, and we have to vary the T, capital T, or we can vary both T on and T in the second one. In variable TRC, we can vary both T on and T. In constant frequency, we have to just vary T on. T is fixed.
Source.
harmonics. Okay, so if you compare, if you come to the fundamental AC harmonic frequency, it is same as the chopper frequency only. Okay, so these AC frequencies, what we are talking about, these are undesirable. Actually, we have to eliminate them because they interference with other loads connected to the DC source, and these causes radio frequency interference through conduction and electromagnetic radiations. Okay, so mainly they are disturbing. They cause these. They cause radio frequency interfaces. What is the principle used? Conduction or by electromagnetic radiation. So, in order to eliminate this AC harmonics, mainly we have to take a LC filter. Okay, so we have to incorporate a LC filter between the chopper and the DC source. Okay, so this filter, what is the help of this filter means? This filter will be keeping the harmonic content in the source current due to the chopper within permissible limits. This will limit the value. This LC filter will be limiting the value of the harmonics. Okay, so if you take a higher chopper frequencies at higher chopper kilohertz like that, if you take the higher chopper frequencies, harmonics can be reduced to a tolerable level by cheaper filters only. These cost nothing. Okay, so from this fact, from this accept, I can say that chopper can be operated. Chopper always will be operated high frequency possibly values. This is the first assumptions I have made from the summary. And second one is, the load terminal voltage is not a perfect drive, direct voltage. Okay, so in addition to direct components, it has harmonics of the chopping frequency and its multiples. Multiples of harmonics means first harmonic, third harmonic, fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic. Like that, there will be presenting of multiple multiple chopper functions. So the load current also has an AC ripple. So what are the adverse effects on the DC motor performance? I have discussed it before. What happens? Speed will be reduced, torque will be reduced, and the cost will be also increased. So if you give for a given duty ratio, if you have some specific duty ratio, the harmonics in the load voltage have fixed magnitudes. Okay, so this is important point. See here, for a given duty ratio, the harmonics in the load voltage, they have different magnitudes. So there is a harmonic current in the load, and therefore the ripple in the load current will be depending upon the chopper only. Okay, so they depend upon the ripples in the load current, depends upon the load chopper frequency and the load inductance. Right, the ripple in the load current will be decreasing as the chopper frequency increases, or the load connected is increased. If the load current is connected is also increased, then what happens? The ripple in the load current will be decreasing. So in order to eliminate the ripple in the load current, we have to do some measures. Okay, so this chopper, mainly this chopper A, is equipped with ripple. It is operated at highest possible frequency. So the highest possible frequency can be equipped, can be used for operating the class A chopper. Okay, so by doing these assumptions, what we are saying, we can reduce the load current ripple. Still, all the eliminations, all the advantages we have taken. please present means? It is, if it is present above the permissible values, it is reduced by introducing a filter inductor between the chopper and the load. Okay, so we have to introduce one inductive filter between the chopper and the load in order to decrease the load current ripples. Okay, so if you see this, this is the class A chopper. It is one of the number of chopper circuits which are used for control of DC drives. So this chopper, what we have discussed, it is capable of providing only positive current and positive voltage. Okay. So this is a single quadrant chopper. This is capable of providing only positive voltage and current. So where we find the positive voltage and current? In first quadrant. That's why it is called as single quadrant. Okay. So see here. If you change the voltage from capital V to zero, this is the going on situation here. We are decreasing the current from, decreasing the voltage from V to zero, right? In this space, we are not having any voltage, right? We are decreasing the voltage from V to zero. Okay, so because of that, this chopper is also called as duck to duck buck converter and step down chopper. As I am increasing the voltage from capital V to zero, this can also be called as step down chopper. Okay, or seriously, we can call it with other name DC to DC buck converter, BUCK, buck converter. This is having some limitations that voltage is reducing to zero. Okay, so in order to reduce the limitations, we are going for other chopper. This is class B chopper. Okay, this is class B chopper. And see here, I will explain you now class B chopper. So this, the basic principle involved in this chopper B, class B chopper, means if you analyze that principle, you will say that it is a step up chopper and it is also called as boost type DC to DC converter. As the current will be in increasing manner, it is also called as boost type DC to DC converter, and it is also called as step up chopper. Before class A is called as step down. And it is called as DC to DC